next car in the list is a minivan or a van. So minivan is a box shaped car, right? And it's pretty versatile, like I said. So it can be configured just to carry passengers or just to carry cargo. So they are not generally like general cars, like a sedan or a hatch, but then they behave like one. Their handling is like a hatchback or a sedan. It's not that difficult to handle a minivan. They are large in size, but then they're quite okay to handle. It's not that difficult to handle them. And their ground clearance is also not that high. So they're not meant for that off-roading thing. But then it's just that you can say a big hatchback. Of course, they're not related to each other, but then I'm just saying so that you can relate. It's less a big car. So generally you have two categories in this. One is just for the cargo, as you can see right in front of you. So this area is where the driver and the passenger will sit, and the complete area behind it can be used as a cargo area. You can put in any cargo you want. It can also be used to transport freight, and that's all about it. The second category is just a van, or of course it's a pretty confusing thing, but then the second category is for passengers, where you have three rows of seats. Right now I haven't designed, but then I can show you. You have one, then you have one like this, and then again you have one like this. So you have three rows of seats, and it is generally there to carry family in safe and sturdy condition. They are quite economical, like a sedan or a hatchback. They are not that costlier or that pricey to maintain. Their handling is also a car-like thing. So if you are just switching from a hatchback to a minivan, you won't feel that big of a difference. You would take some time to adjust, but then you will feel that home-like thing. As you have been driving a hatchback, it won't be a big headache for you to get habituated with driving a minivan. Next thing is, they're very value for money car. They're not that pricey like a SUV or cheap like a hatchback. They're somewhere in the middle. They solve the general family need. If you have a joint family, if you have members like 5 or 7 and you want to go somewhere, of course a sedan or a hatchback cannot justify that. They can accommodate 5 persons, but then if the number is like 6 or 7, they will fail. So if that kind of requirement you have, you need a minivan or a van. The example would be in India, like you have Maruti Omni or Maruti Eco, or if you go for little powerful vans, or again, like I said, it's a basic categorization, so don't go that deep into it. You can say Maruti Ertiga or Honda Mobilio. So they're kind of that vehicles where you have three rows of seats. You can configure them for cargo, for passengers. They handle like a hatchback. You don't have to worry about their, you know, size, their big size. That is not going to be a big hindrance. And maintenance-wise also, they are not very much, costly. Maintenance is also lower than almost all the pricey variants like SUV or other things. So this is very, very much value for money. And if you have a large family, so that's the option for you. And right now, that's just about the minivan. So if you have the first row and this is empty, it's for the cargo purpose. If you have all the three rows upright, then that is for passenger carrying purpose. And you can configure the van as per your requirement. The next car in the category is the SUV. SUV stands for Sports Utility Vehicle. So the first thing we all need to understand is this is not a different category altogether. It is a category of utility vehicle. So any utility vehicle for that matter, they are designed either to carry freight or to carry passengers. So SUV is that utility vehicle which has got some basic sports quality in it. They are not mainly into economical driving or fuel efficiency. They are mainly into performance driving. So if it is utility vehicle, even if it is carrying 7 passengers on board or 7 people on board, still companies make SUVs capable enough to touch 200, 250. Awesome acceleration they have, quite powerful engines they have. The ground clearance is pretty high. The center of gravity is pretty high. They're very much powerful than a station wagon or a minivan. They're pretty costlier, even pricier than minivan and a state wagon or station wagon. I'm so sorry. So that is how SUV is different than other utility vehicles. I can give you examples, like we have Tata Safari, Range Rover, Sport, Evoque, then you have Mahindra Scorpio, then you have Toyota Fortuner. They all are SUVs. So all the names which I just took, they are similar as per the kind of work they do. They're capable enough to carry 5 or 7 people on board, a lot of luggage, and they are not economical in any terms. They're quite heavy as far as the weight is concerned. They have massive acceleration, designed to touch 200-250 as top speed. And the basic thing is, they have high ground clearance. So your variants in SUV, which are 4x4 or 4x2, which I will explain in a later on video again. So what we need to understand from this is, without getting confused, that they are that kind of vehicles who are designed to go anywhere. The vehicles with anywhere going capability. That can be a simple terrain, that can be a desert, that can be village roads, big potholes. So these are the kind of vehicles which are designed to keep you safe, which are designed to keep you going on these kind of roads, and they are designed to handle these kind of problems. So nothing would happen to them. In general terms, I'm saying nothing would happen to them. The other parts of SUVs, which is not similar to all the other categories, is they're quite heavy and the safest car options available in today's world are the SUVs. So of course I'll make a different video altogether about them, but then right now to understand, I believe that would be all. That's all about SUV. Now we will talk about the pickup trucks. Pickup trucks is the last topic to be discussed today. So pickup truck is not a big thing. They are generally again a derivative or of a station wagon or a minivan or a SUV. The only thing is, just keep these three cars in mind. The station wagon, the minivan and the SUV. The only difference is the third row, which either is designed to carry passengers or to carry a luggage, is open, right? As you can see. So imagine we have a minivan and this thing is completely open. So there is no restriction. You can keep a lot of luggage and even something which will exceed the height of the vehicle. So pickup trucks is generally designed to carry 2 or 4 passengers. Generally, they have either 1 row of seats or 2 row of seats. And the third row, that is a huge bay area where you can put a lot of luggage. So then they are also a kind of utility vehicle, but then where luggage is more into importance. Like if you have seen in construction area, you see vehicles with the last area open where they keep either a generator or a big machine with 2 or 4 workmen inside. So pickup truck is generally used where you need to carry people and luggage as well, and where the luggage may not go inside this kind of body or this kind of body or this kind of body. So there is no overhead restriction to put in the luggage. You have the freedom to go to bring something or to load something which has got which height or whose height will be taller than this much length. Examples in India are very less. You can say the Tata Xenon XT and the Mahindra Gateway, which is a pickup truck version of the Scorpio. So friends, that's all for today. So like I said at the very beginning, this categorization is just to simplify how we receive a car or how we take a car. Once we see a car, just to clarify or just to know whether it's a hatchback or a sedan or a convertible or a SUV. So this was not a very, very deep categorization. This was just to make the things simpler for all the people. And the next video or maybe the next to next video is going to be about the type of sports cars we have and how a SUV functions. How, because they are very broad thing. Right now, I'm really sorry, I haven't explained them properly. But then each one of them needs at least a video of 10-15 minutes where I can explain how they work, what are the different categorizations, and how they justify their existence. So right now, really thanks for watching my video. And do drop in your comments and let me know if you want me to make a video on a different thing altogether or a different topic altogether. So let's meet next week, and thanks.